Yo, it's been a while since we talked about kicks, or I should say rather since we did a version of Today in Sneaks, so let's get that out of the way and get it cracking right now. Welcome to Today in Sneaks. I am your host, Jacques Slade, and there have been a few different things happening here on this channel, but right now let's talk about some sneakers. First off, the NBA Media Day kicked off with a bunch of different kicks popping up, starting with what I think was the highlight of the day, which was LeBron's colorway of the LeBron 15. I don't know what this one is called, but people are calling it the Cleveland Cavalier colorway. Either way, I thought it was dope. We also saw a pair of 32s for Oladipo. We saw a pair of 32s for Greg Monroe, and the Lakers even did a kicks cam and showed off some crazy explosive, the Kobe AD, the Kyrie, a Paul George. And actually, if you go back to last week, Steph actually previewed the low top version of the Curry, which looks a little different in my opinion. I like the way the high looks more than the low, but the low is definitely something I want to play in when it comes to the Curries. Now, talking about Adidas collaborations, Mastermind has had some of the best looks we've seen so far. For their latest collection, they take their creative hand to the EQT Support 9317 and the Support Ultra. From the looks of it, each model will either be available in black or in blue, and they obviously have a ton of boost there. And it looks like they have some nice materials with them on the upper, like a mix of mesh and maybe some suede and some leather there. Mastermind is known for their quality collaborations, and this one is no exception. You can look for these to actually release this weekend on the 29th at select Adidas retailers. All right, I know I already talked about the NBA Media Day, but Jordan Brand, I'm going to say, stole the show with the player-exclusive colorway of the Jordan 32 for Russell Westbrook. The color is an obvious nod to the Oklahoma City Thunder with a ton of orange all over the upper, but the pops of blue are what really make this model stand out. You can also see they use the leather on the ankle portion, which gives the model a little bit of a luxury feel, in my opinion, and then they have fly knit at the front of the shoe that really pops as well with the blue lacing mixed in. If I'm going to be honest with you guys, I doubt these actually release to the public, but stay tuned because you never know. The Off-White Nike sneaker collaboration is easily the biggest thing happening in sneakers right now, and it looks like Virgil is taking his talent to the performance side with a customized version of the Nike Zoom 5 for Eliud Kipchoge. I think I said that right. Kipchoge actually just ran the Berlin Marathon and tried to break the world record, but fell short by less than a minute. Not that he didn't win the race. He actually still won the race and obviously got a customized version of the Air Zoom Fly from Virgil. If you watched Breaking 2, you actually saw that Eliud actually ran the race in 2 hours and 25 seconds in near perfect conditions. Though breaking the world record is still one of his goals, the win and the custom pair from Virgil isn't a bad concession. As for what I'm rocking today, it is this shoe. This is the LeBron 15. If you haven't seen the unboxing, I'll link it down in the description below. As always, guys, I appreciate you. Make sure you like, favorite, subscribe, and all that good stuff. And this is the return of Today in Sneaks. I got to get this show back. I like it. I like doing this show, giving you the daily news of sneakers. All right, guys, I'll see you soon. Peace.